So we are looking at transformation. As we know, we have four main transformations. That is a reflection, a translation, a rotation, and enlargement. However, in order for us to carry out these transformations, we need support. For example, for reflection, we need to have a mirror line. Now, a mirror line is a line. Actually, it is a straight line. It could be a vertical straight line or horizontal straight line. Sometimes it could be a slanting line, that is y is equal to x or y is equal to negative x, as you can see there. Also, when carrying out a translation, we need a column vector. The column vector will be in the position of y and x. X will be on top, y will be below. This tells us that we shall always be moving the x movement first, then the y movement next. However, we could move the x movement on the negative and the y movement on the negative, or x movement on the negative, the y movement on the positive, and the other final one could be x on the positive, y on the negative. But also, when you are carrying out a rotation, we need what we call a center of rotation and the angle of rotation. Usually we have three different types of angles. That is 90 degrees clockwise, which we always know it as negative 90. 90 anti-clockwise, usually known as positive 90. But for us mainly we shall use clockwise and anti-clockwise. Now, this is one way, this is another way. We are not allowed to write both of them. We either take 90 clockwise or we take negative 90. But first we shall focus more on taking clockwise. Also, we have angle 180 degrees. As you can see it. And finally, we have enlargement, where we need the center for enlargement and the scale factor. How do we get the scale factor? Usually, if you have your object and image, you need a scale factor. On the other way, if you have your image and the scale factor, you can obtain your image. Now, here we have a question to help us. We have given our question and we are told to describe the given shapes under transformation. Describe fully the single transformation as shown. The first one is telling us we are given shape T that is there. We are asking to describe it fully. How did it move onto A? Now, we have four different transformations. However, we said when we want to check if it is a reflection, we can use a tracing paper and we flip it over. So once you can flip over the tracing paper and the shape can regain its look, then that will show a reflection. If it is a translation, we get our tracing paper and slide it. If we can slide our tracing paper and the shape can regain the look, that will be clear that it is a translation. Rotation. We take our tracing paper and we rotate it. If we can rotate our tracing paper and we bend the loop, then that will be clear. And finally, enlargement, we don't need any help because for enlargement cases, the object and the image size will be different. Now let's look at the first one. T onto A. Shall get our tracing paper. We shall put it on top of the shape. We shall drawing our object, and remember our object is T. If we flip over to A, and while flipping over, it can clearly join into A. This is showing us that this is a reflection. Now, after knowing the reflection, you must talk about the middle line. The middle line is that position that equally divides the shape, and it can join over just like a mirror. If I take this shape, 1, 2 and a half, and I go over the middle line, 1, 2 and a half, then that clearly shows that it's a proper mirror line. Now, what will be the name for a mirror line? You can say y-axis, -3.5. So the mirror line will be called y is equal to -3.5. Let's go to the next shape. T onto B. So when we look at our object T, we want to go to our image B. We get our tracing paper. We put back the object. If we slide it, no, it will not enter, meaning it's not for sliding. If we flip it over, no, it doesn't enter. It means not for flipping over. Therefore, finally, if we rotate it, yes, it can enter. So if we conclude that it is a rotation. But we need to know the center of rotation. We use what we call try and error method. Pinch somewhere and rotate. If you rotate and does not enter, no, you move backwards. You pinch somewhere else and rotate. Yes, if it can enter, then we prove that that is our center of rotation and the center is 0, 0. After getting the center, we also look for the angle under which we are rotating. Go back to your center, go to the arrow there, stand with the arrow, and carry out your rotation. As you rotate, watch the arrow. Watch the arrow. So the arrow will make a 90 moving familiar at once and clockwise direction coming 90 degrees. So we shall conclude it is 90 degrees anti-clockwise. Finally, T onto C. 90 is there, my C is up. If I move from my T and I slide, and it can enter properly, we conclude that is a translation. After concluding the translation, we have to know our column vector. Now go back and count the movements till you reach. First horizontal movement, -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, and -6. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So we moved -6 and +9. That will become our column vector. After that, we are supposed to construct now. You are given enlargement, your top center is 0, 0, and the scale factor is -3. Where is your center? There. Where is your object? Here. To carry out enlargement, we need to know the column vectors of each corner. -1, -1, -1, -2, -1, and -1, -3. You get your scale factor that is given as -3 and multiply. When you multiply the 3, 3, 6, 3, 3, 9. So these images we shall have to plot them in our ship. Three, we shall plot it there. Three, we shall plot it there. And three, nine, we shall plot it up here. After plotting, we get our ruler and join them. Hence, this is our enlargement. We call it B. Let's go to the next part. Reflection, the mirror, Y is equal to negative X. Reflection, the mirror, Y is equal to negative. First of all, where is that? Negative will be there. We shall call that mirror line Y is equal to negative X. Now we need to move our object across the mirror line. So each corner will move along. Y took the mirror line, then horizontal, one took the mirror line. That will give us a clear movement across. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That will give us a clear movement across. And finally, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Giving us a clear movement across. Hence, we join the corners of our image. Then we call it the letter given, that is letter A. Next is rotation. Rotate T, set them negative 4, negative 2. Where is negative 4, negative 2? There. So that is our set of rotation. We have to rotate shape T. Now go back, put your shape there. Our center is outside, so I have to create another object T so that it is inside our center of rotation. Keep the arrow and pinch at the arrow. We have to rotate 90 degrees clockwise. 90 degrees clockwise. Move, move. When you finish the 90 movement, look at the position of your former object. There it is. Remove the tracing paper and mark the points, then join them with your ruler. So that is your image, and we are told to call it letter F. Now finally, we have a translation. By 6 on the positive, then 4 on the negative. We get our tracing paper, we just put it on top of T, there is our shape. So we need to focus here. We move 6 steps on the positive, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Our shape is now here. After, we move negative 4 steps, that is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. Now, finally, our shape has been translated to this position. Let's mark the points. After marking, we join the ruler. And we name it G. Now we have covered up all the transformations, and our question is over. Thank you for watching. If you like the discussion, you can subscribe to my channel. My name is Ishan Dharma. Thank you.